started now. So this is a case of primary infertility with diminished ovarian reserve, AMH of 0.3 only, nanograms per ml. On ultrasound we could easily see the deep-seated ostia. So on hysteroscopy, this is a hysteroscopic findings, pale endometrium with features of endometritis. Definitely there are features of endometritis, and these are the 20 care images. Yes, this is the right ostia, this is the left ostia. So we'll be definitely taking endometrial biopsy for TB PCR and TB culture. We'll be definitely taking endometrial biopsy for TB PCR and TB culture. So, and these are the features of the endometritis. So endocytes will come and they will try to release this archaeation or the susceptate uterine cavity. So these are the endocytes. So here a good cut and the fundus to release the archaeation should do the job. 3 or 4 cuts are enough to release the soil patient. So point to be noted here is that keep intrauterine pressure below 80 millimeters of mercury, below 80 millimeters to be, in order to be on the safer side, because spiral artery pressure is not more than 80 millimeters of mercury. So otherwise the chances of air embolism are high, and try to avoid bubbles. So we can clearly see the myometrium here. The normal cavity has been restored. We can see now the archaeation is released. We could not cut more because of the chances of injury to myometrium, and that may lead to rupture or muscle compromise in pregnancy. So this patient, high chances for genital tuberculosis are there, very high chances. So ostia appears closed, pinhole ostia, this ostia appears closed. We are sending greetings from Harkar Eye Center, Srinagar, India, J&K.